Is this Peter?
Speaking.
Peter, listen, my name is Roy D. Mercer. My buddy Hasty Burford down there had a boat redone by y'all.
Who?
Hasty Burford, he got one of them Chris Crafter boats down there, a 19-foot, 55 model Capri boat.
Yes.
Y'all worked on it down there. Listen, he and his wife, Lou Ella, and me and my wife, Sharon Jean, was down there this weekend on the lake of Winnipesaukee down there, and my wife was trying to get into the boat. And she didn't want to get her feet wet, so she took her shoes off, and she's coming across the back of that thing, drug her foot across the back of it, and got about a 4-inch splinter down there in her foot.
Mm-hmm.
And we need to get somebody to take care of that daggum thing. I'm thinking it's y'all's problem to done it, because you had the rotted wood in there and didn't get it out.
Where's the boat located?
Huh?
Where's the boat located?
It's on the Lake Winnipesaukee right now.
Would you plan on having this work done?
No, it done been done. Y'all done it and did a bad job of it. My wife got a splinter in her foot, cost me $390 so far.
What boat is this? I don't do any work on Winnipesaukee.
Hey, Steve Burford, no, you done it. He drug it in there to you. The boat was on the lake. You hard of hearing?
I have a bad connection here, so I'm trying to understand what you're saying.
What I'm saying is that I got my wife hurt on a boat that y'all was supposed to redo.
Which boat? What's the name of the boat?
The name of the boat is the Sugar Smack.
Never heard of it.
Well, by God, it's Hasty Burford. You worked on it, I don't know, it's been a couple of years ago.
Nope, I don't. No, I did not. Yeah. I don't know that, but what's the name? What's the fellow? Who owns it?
Hasty Burford owned it. Him and his wife, Lou Ella. It's a Sugar Smack down there. They have it out there on Lake Winnipesaukee. We're up here at Dixville Notch, New Hampshire.
Yeah, nope.
No, well, by God, it is. Hasty didn't lie to me. Y'all done it down there.
Nope,
I need $390 out of your smart ass, or I'm coming down there and whooping it.
Well, I guess you're going to have to, because I have no idea who that is or what boat it is.
How big a boy are you?
Huh?
How big of a feller are you?
Well. No, I don't recognize the owner's name, nor do I recognize the boat.
Well, you work on every daggone boat you work in there? He said Peter was the one to run the outfit down there. I ain't sure whether you done the work on it or not, but you's responsible for it and going to take a ass whooping when it gets dished out.
Joke.
No, sir. I'm going to be on you like a wet fart on satin undies.
Okay.
Well, it ain't funny because I'm getting ready to beat somebody like a stray dog down there.
Well, I have no idea who you are. I have no idea who the owner is.
You're getting ready to find out who I am. How big a fella are you? How long is it going to take me to just wipe a floor with you? Well, it ain't going to be funny because I'm going to tear into somebody like a hobo does a bologna sandwich.
Yeah, okay.
I guarantee
you. Thank you for your call.
I ain't going to. Hey, listen.
Bye-bye.
Hey, don't you hang up on. Hey! I'll be go to hell.
Hello?
Could you just send a check to the Dr. Joe Costa down there?
Yeah, I'm going to shove it up his ass. Sideways.
Oh, that'd be a bad place to have a rotted wooden splinter right there.
Hey, Peter, how you doing?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
How you doing?
We're good. Doing fine. This is Phil and Brent and Roy D. Mercer from KMOD Radio down in Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Oh, wonderful. So my ass is all over the radio.
I'm getting ready to knock a bunch of pop knots on your head you could navigate with.
Oh, and you hang around with my brother?
Wow, by God.
I'm losing more and more respect for you as I know you.